Start recording. Okay, so and share my screen. Okay, let me share my screen. Fine. So who wants to see? I want to show what Gandha sent. What Madhura sent me. Okay, so one of the problems I will show you. So this is the rectangular path, right? This is puzzle number 2. Can you see it? Can you see it on the screen? Everyone can see it. Give me a thumbs up if you can see it. Yeah. This is how it will look like if you have done it. Okay. I think Madhura has done it very well, this problem. And this problem is also easier. See, there is not too many doubts because from A to B, all the nodes or all the vertices, you will call it, right? All the thing where the paths diverge or converge, all of them are in the direction from A to B. General direction. Nothing is on the other side, right? Whatever that you will go, everything will be on this side. So all the vertices are valid vertices. So you simply can go on applying the formula, right? I think 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3 will become.
So yeah. Can you rotate the image?
Yeah, I am not able to because in this, I will take a screenshot and then rotate, I think, so that way. Right? So, or let me download the thing. So this is save image, copy image. Okay, let me do this. And what is there in the Mac for? Oops, fine. I don't know what is the tool for image in Mac. Huh? What is the photo? Is there photo editor? Okay, let me open photos and no. It's okay, bear with me. I think the next time I will have it all. Okay, it is opened up somewhere. Where did it go? Okay, photos, okay. Get started, let me see. Not now. Drag picture, choose import from file, connect to camera. Okay, memories. Okay, leave it. I think right now you just go with the what I was showing on. Why it is not? Has opened it in this one itself, huh? Let's go ahead. Fine. You can, but anyway, I think you can still read it. I will get it all properly rotated and thing next time when I show. But I hope you got this right. It is fairly easy to see, right? How everything gets added up, right? Simply thing is that whenever you are going. If there are two nodes, two sides are converging into a node, then you add the numbers. Otherwise, you carry forward the numbers. This is what has been done. So everywhere it is carry forward or add. Carry forward or add. With that thing, finally, when you do all of this thing, it is coming out with 194, I think. Right? I have not verified exactly going, but I've just looked at it briefly and everything is correct. And by the way, you can also see the Fibonacci series coming up. 3, 5, 8, 21, 34, 53, all these numbers appear here. Okay, they will appear due to particular nature of those Fibonacci series. But this is how it is to be done. Anyone else has done the thing? Shreyas, you want to share your triangular?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I have allowed screen sharing. So let me stop sharing so that you can... Yeah, you can. I will stop sharing and I will go to, yeah. So you can share.
So the triangular one.
Triangular one, yeah. Triangular one you can share. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, you can. right? And there is a middle R also. Actually, from here, you can even take the arrow, which is, yeah, I understand you did this shortest path. So you generally took the direction. Okay, it's okay. I mean, as long as that logic is there, it is okay. So you can put one, right? Starting from A at the starting point, it will be one. Then the next two nodes where it can reach to, those also will be, first one will be one, but second one can be two actually. Okay, 1+1, 2, because you can go from the horizontally from the top and come down. Yeah, you might say that I'm not exactly going in the direction of B, it is slightly going. That's why I said that it is okay. Relax that rule a little bit. Okay, as long as you are not grossly going away from A to B, slightly taking a longer path, it's okay. But that way you will be able to make it one, and the other one will become 1+1, 2, right? And then this one. So you are not numbered it, but you can number it. But it will be more than, definitely it will be more than two. Okay?
Okay,
because
sir,
you can go horizontally, then come down, again go horizontally, again come down, and again go horizontally. That way also you can do it, those paths. Or, yes, so all those intermediate two nodes, I think you have not connected, but you can also connect them. Okay? All right. So that is what. Anyone? Okay, fine. Anyone else has got any? Yeah, screen snip tool should be there. Yeah. I think should be there. But it's okay. We'll do it. I think. Fine. All right. Anyone does that polygonal or whatever parallelopiped figure or the hexagonal figure, anybody did? The formula is same. The formula is very, very same. Okay. Only thing is that I think at every point, what is the question that you have to ask is, can I take this path? Even though the path exists, can I take it, or I cannot take it because it is going away from my destination? As long as we have a clear definition of that and we can determine it, then everything else is very simple, right? Yeah, once you are able to get that, then it is very, and that's why that rectangular puzzle which Madhura solved, there was everything was very, very clear there, right? So you could simply go on adding it, right? Okay, all right. So what we will do is we will go to this week's puzzle, okay, and we will think around it. So what was the puzzle? Who all have looked at this table tennis puzzle?
Sir, one second, sir.
Yeah.
So you said that there's a name for that, finding how many paths to go. Now, what's the name for it?
So that is a graph. Okay. So the general theory, mathematical, what you call, area of that is called as graph theory. And the particular name for these graphs where you have controls. Okay. So it is not like anybody can go in any direction. You go from a starting point to a ending point, and you do not do loops in between. Right, those types of graphs are called as directed acyclic graphs. Okay, and it is a slightly looks directed means there is a clear direction. Acyclic means you don't loop through. Okay, you only go forward. You don't never come back. Right, and if at all you want to see this, yeah, this was the truth tables that I was explaining last time. There is a pretty much, but there is also directed acyclic graph, yeah, DAG it is called as. Okay, so where there is a clear direction and ending. So fairly you will, on Wikipedia you will find a fairly complicated, means detailed explanation, but it is all, I have given you a quick introduction to it, and this is of fundamental importance in computer science. Okay, very much, absolutely important. Okay, so you can, so the name is called as directed acyclic graph. Okay, you got it? If you want to note down, you can just, if you want the URL, I will just quickly send it on the chat. Right. Let me get to the chat and everyone. Yeah, this is the URL. Okay, let's get back. Fine. So this is what you wanted, right, Pranav?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. So let us look at this week's problem. Okay, so let me pin my video and go to single this mode. Yeah, this is better. Fine. So this is a right, fairly simple thing, right? But then there is a aha into it, and then there is more things to look at it. Okay. So what does it look like? So there is a table tennis tournament, knockout tournament, right? And first one is fairly simple, right? I mean, you know, there are 11 players, and then there will be a tournament. There will be a game between two players. If someone is not paired, then he will get a bye, right? You are familiar with it, bye, getting a bye, right? So 11 players you start with, and then till you find the winner. So first time there will be 5 games, because 10 players will play 5 games. One person will get a bye, right? Okay. Now next round there will be 5 winners. From the first round plus one player who got a bye, so 6 players. So they will end up playing 3 games, right? And that will result in 3 winners, right? So now 3 winners again, you cannot pair them all. So 2 of them will play, and 1 of them will get a bye. So 2 of them will play. So that will result in 1 game and resulting in 1 player, and that will get added to the bye person who got a bye. So now 2 players are left. And then you will play them, and that will be the final, because there are only 2 players left. So once they play and you get a winner, he is the final winner. So you will have 5 games in the first round, 3 games in the second round, 1 game in the third round, and 1 final round game, right? So 10 matches, right? Everybody saw that? If you start with 11 players and play through the knockout tournament, table tennis, how many games will be there till you get the winner? So we did this 5, 3, like it is shown in the picture, right? Similarly, you did it, and then you got 10 matches. You got it? Everyone got it? Let me know. If you not got it, then I'm assuming that you have read the puzzle, okay? And I'm not reading the puzzle in the class. If somebody is not getting it, please let me know now, because then I will wait for a minute or so. Send me feedback on chat. Yeah, Madhura got it. That is good. Anybody who has not got it, from 11 players to determine a winner, 10 games have to be played in 4 rounds. Shreyas, you got it? Swadha?
Sir, in the second match, how will there be 6 players? It should be 5, no?
No, 5 players, but in the first round, 1 person got a bye, na? So he will join them, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so that will become 5 plus 1, 6. And then hence they will play 3 rounds. I mean, 3 games, not 3 rounds, 3 games. And then there will be again 3 players. One of them will get a bye, but other 2 will play, right? Okay, Pranav, Sai Pranav.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you got it?
Yes, sir, I got it. So I done class.
You've done it already, okay, okay. So now let us look at it scenario A then. Okay, first puzzle. Now there is a new National Public School is holding a championship. 53 entries are there this time. Okay, it's a bigger school, more entries are there. Now 53 people are going to play. How many games you will need, okay, before you declare the winner? How many games?
Sir, can I tell you the answer?
We will, you can privately message it to me. Okay, yeah, Sai Pranav, you have got it right. Don't tell the answer yet.
915.
Yeah, that is right. Sorry, who said something I didn't get? Ahan?
I was on mute, and then my computer was telling me the time. Every
15
minutes, my computer tells me.
Okay. Yeah, I heard something like 10-15. Okay, Swadha, yes, you are right. I hope you did not have to look at that inverted explanation, right? You just got it yourself, right? Anyone else? Madhura, you got the number. Something somewhere has gone wrong, I think. You got more than what is required. Okay, fine. Now I will stop here and I will tell. So anyway, if you have tried it very well, if after trying, if you have either got it yourself, or then you can also read what is there given in the inverted text. Okay, see, there are two ways of doing like this. Okay, solving this problem. Okay, yeah, Shreyas, you got it right. Yeah, right. So there are two ways of solving. One is called as a meticulous hard work way, okay, and then there is also a smart way insight, that is called an aha insight. The hard way will be you will start doing the division. 53 entries, 53 by 2, 26 games in the first round, 1 bye. Now 26 games will produce 26 winners, plus 1 will become 27 in the second round, again divided by 2, then you will get 13 games plus 1 bye. Right, so first round there will be 26 games, second round there will be 13 games, third round there will be 6 games, right? So like this, so like this you will do it, and then you will find the answer. Okay, answer it will come to. Okay, anyone did like this? And it is, there is nothing wrong in it. Okay, this is how you will do it, this is how computers will also do it. Okay, but there is an easy direct path to the answer. Okay, the answer is 52. Okay, 52 games need to be played to find the winner. 26 plus 13 plus 6 plus whatever it is, plus after that you will get right, actually no, 26 plus 1 is 27. Next round there will be not 13, there will be 14, I think. So there will be 7. Okay, so 26 13 and then 7. Okay, so that is how you will get 52. Okay, but there is an easy way to think is, in every game that you play, okay, one person gets eliminated, right? Every game you play, two people play the game, one person gets eliminated, right? In every game, only one person gets eliminated. Okay, now to find the winner, there are 53 people, 52 have to be eliminated, then only one will be left, right? So irrespective of the number of buys, how many happen in the first round, second round, so straight away you can bypass it and you can tell that 53 minus 52 will give one. So there will be 52 games will be required to find the eliminator. And this is the same answer. Then 127, if you say players are there, 126 games will have to be played in the knockout way with buys to find the winner. Doesn't matter. N minus 1. Right? So this is called as the aha insight. Very good, right? Just logic, right? Application of the logic will take you directly to the answer without doing all this mathematics. Everyone got the logic? Let me know if you got it. Yes, yes, yes. Or if you didn't get it, then say no and or call out and say we want to understand. Yeah, Madhura, yes.
Sir, can you explain it again?
Okay, I will explain it again. See, it is like this. No matter how many players you start with, right? It is a knockout tournament, you say, so that there will be N number of games where two people will play. And sometimes if one player may get a bye, that's okay. Right, but in every game that is played, one person gets eliminated. Whoever loses the game gets eliminated. So he is no longer there in the next stage. Right? Yes? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? So this is like Wimbledon or whatever that you are watching, right? Every time there is a knockout tournament, you know, in the Wimbledon, every time whoever is the winner goes to the next round, or French Open or whatever it is, tennis that you are watching, right? So only the winner goes to the next round. So that, what is the logic? Every game, one person will get eliminated. Is it correct? One person will go out of the reckoning, out of the entire tournament. For yes, every sir. Game played, one. Now, if you start with 53 players, to find the winners, there can be only one winner, correct? Correct. Finally, there will be only one winner, right?
Yes, sir.
So how many people have to go out to find, to get that one person? N minus one. So 53 you start, 52 have to go out, correct?
Yes.
Now, each one of them can go out only in one game. You cannot eliminate two people in one game, right? In one game, there will be one winner, one loser. The loser goes out, correct?
Yeah.
So to let go of 52 people, how many games will be required? Same number, 52 games will be required. Right?
Yes.
Right? So this is the logic which gets you straight to the answer without doing all the hard mathematics. Right? This is also mathematics, but this is a higher order of mathematics. Right?
Yeah.
So this is what I would like to this one. So so this is what we want to develop, okay, as the insights. Okay, so you have to look at the thing and see how you can approach it. Now the same problem, I'm going to now go to the next level of the problem. Okay, so far so good. You answered, you know how to answer now how many games it will take to find a winner. No matter, even if I take 1233 players are there in a knockout tournament, you immediately know what, how many games will be required to find the winner. It will be 1,232, one less than the total number of players, right? Doesn't matter. If it is 1 million players are there, then one less than 1 million, right? 9,99,999 games will have to be played.
Sir, right? But what if two people are going to be selected, then it should be two less than the number.
But two, how will you select two? Winner is always one, right?
So first and second, if you want to select like that.
No, that is a different question altogether. See, the question is here, finding out the winner, right? Finding out the winner is the question. What is the question? You just see, that's why I think you have to be careful to look at what is the question and only answer that. Right? There is a scenario B is a different question, or scenario C you might have, that's a different question. But the question that is asked is only find the winner. Right? So finding the winner is only this much. Okay, now let us go to the next question, scenario B. Yeah, the first one was easy. Many of you have got the insight and got it very well. Even if you didn't get it, no problem. Now you know. Now the question is different. Okay, whether it is the first question scenario, explanation scenario, or scenario in both cases, now the question is different. Question is not how many games it will take to find the winner. Now, how many buys are given before you declare the winner? So how many buys were given totally? Okay. You understand the question, right? How many people got buys, or how many times, how many buys were given total? I will not say how many people got buys, because some person may have got buy twice. That may happen. So, but I will not say it is one person. I will still say it as two buys were given. Right? So like this, how many buys were given? Right? Again, if you go back to the original way we have solved the first 11 problem, let us consider 11 players. Right? Let us consider 11 players. First round, there were 5 games. One person got a buy. So you count it as one. Okay? Second round, 5 + 1, 6 players, there were no buys. So 3 games were played, no buys, right? Third round, there was one buy was given, right? So the 2 buys were given total, okay? 2 buys were given, because third round, again, one person got a buy. And then after that, there were no. So only 2 buys were given when there were 11 players.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, I think he got 4 buys in the tournament.
I think if you are considering are you answering the 37 players or which one? I was just explaining with 11 players. If you are explaining with 11 players, there are only 2 buys are given.
I'm saying it's 53.
And for 53, you are answering. Huh? Okay, let us see for 53. 53 players, if they are there. First round, what will happen? 26 games and one person will get a buy. So buy equal to 1. Right? Second round, there will be 27 players left, because 26 went out. 27 players left. Again, 13 games will happen. One buy will be given. So buys is equal to 2. Okay. Now 27 minus 13, 14 players are left. Third round, there will be 7 games and no buys. Fine. 0 buys. So buys remain 2. Now there are 7 players left. Right, I am just writing it down on this one. So start with first round, 26 games plus one bye. right? Second round, it is 27, so it is 13 games plus one bye. Total is two byes. Third round, it is 14 players, so only 7 games, so 0 byes. Equal to total byes remain 2. Okay, fourth round, how many will happen? Now 7 players, they will end up playing 3 games plus 1 bye. So total byes will become 3 byes. Right? Fifth round. What is the fifth round? Now three players have got a thing plus one person is joining. So total four players. So they will play two games and zero byes. So that will remain three byes. Right? Now two games will result in two players getting eliminated and two players going forward. So sixth round, there are only two players left. Two players left, they will play one game, which will declare the winner and zero byes. So how many byes are given? Three byes, right? Anybody see any other number?
Sir, I got the same answers.
You got the same number, three byes?
Yes,
sir. Sai Pranav, you got four byes. How is it? Maybe somewhere you calculated this one, huh? Just check again.
Sir, we just have to find out whenever an odd number comes and then you add a bye.
Correct, correct. That is correct. That is absolutely correct. Right? So there are three byes that are there, right? Now, so now, but this is a meticulous way of doing it, right? Now, if I have to ask the same question for 37, then you will say 37 is odd. So first time there will be a bye, then 18 will be there, 18 plus 1, 19 will be there, right? Second round, again, it's an odd number. So again, second round also one bye will be there. So total byes is 2. Third round, there is 9 games will happen. So 9 plus 1, 10 people will be there. So now third round, there will not be any bye. So then 2 byes, then 5 people will be left. 5 people means again, one person will get a bye, right? So that will result in 2 plus 1, 3 players in the next round. Again, it is odd. So again, one person will get a bye. So 1 plus 1, 2 will be there. So total 4 byes will come if you are 37 players. Right, just do it yourself and check. If you start with 37 players, you will require 4 byes before you find the eventual winner. Anybody got the same or different, or check it out. Same 4 byes. But what is the thing earlier? I hope you got all of you got 4 byes, right? Or still doing it? Swada?
Sir, I got 3 byes, sir.
You got 3 byes. Again, check it. First round, when you are starting with 37 players, not 53. 53 okay. We already said. Okay, Sai Pranav is saying he got 4. 37, just do it. So 37, I will just do it very quickly here. 37 is equal to 18 games plus 1 is equal to 1 bye, right? First round. Second round, 18 games will give 18 winners. So 18 plus 1, 19 games. So 19 is equal to 9 games, 9 into 2 players plus 1 bye. So total number is equal to 2 byes. Okay. Third round, 9 winners plus 1 will make 10. 10 players is equal to 5 games plus 0 byes. Is equal to, so total number of byes is 2, right? Fourth round, 5 players means there will be 5 is equal to 2G, 2 games into 2 players plus 1 bye. Is equal to total number of byes will become 3. Fifth round, 2 games will give 2 winners plus 1 bye person as there. So 3 players, 3 is equal to 1G plus 1 bye. 3 players means one person will get a bye, right? So total byes is 4 byes. Now, last round, one game would have produced one winner plus the person who got the bye is joining it. So 2 players, 2 is equal to 1 game to find the winner and zero buys. Because final round there are only two players, so zero. So what is the answer? Four buys. Okay. I think I ended up giving the last one to Sai Pranav, but I hope you got the thing, right? So it starts with 37, 19, 10, 5, 3, 2. So whenever there are odd number, you get a buy. 37, you get a buy. 19, you get a buy. 5, you get a buy. 3, you get a buy. So total number of buys is 4. Got it? Let me know. See, don't shy. If you have not got it, let me know. Because then... Yeah? I hope everyone got it. Yeah? Sai Pranav, you got it? Four?
Yes, sir. So I got four on it.
Okay. Pranav? Riyas?
Yes.
Ahan? Swada, you got it or you want to go over it again? Let me know.
No, sir.
Okay, everybody got it. Four now. Fine now, but the thing is, what is the formula? Now there is no formula, right? So now.
Sir, even I got four buys.
Very nice, very nice. Correct. Four buys is the right answer, and now you know the technique of how to find it very well. Now, but we are not stopping here, right? We are looking at mathematical insights, aha insights. So we have to find a way. Is there a way? Now, earlier I gave you a formula, right? N minus one. Doesn't matter how much is the N. You said 1,233 players. You could still find out very easily, immediately in 1 second, you could give how many games were needed to give it, right? Find the winner. You could just give it in 1 second, immediately, irrespective of how high the number is. Just subtract one from it and then you get the number. But in case of buys, now there is no formula. Or is there a formula? Is there a way that you can get it? Right? So obviously, there is no obvious way, but there is an inobvious way. Okay. And that is what we are going to discuss today. Probably we may not be able to finish the discussion. Okay. But this is where we come to the topic of number systems. Okay. And we start discussing with everybody understand the decimal number system?
Yes, sir.
What is the decimal number system? How many numbers, basic numbers are there in this?
10 digits.
10, right?
10 digits.
10 digits.
10 digits.
Yeah, you are right. You are right. Everyone understands? Swada? Ahan? Avnish? Ashish? Everyone yes, understands this, right? 10, right? You have learned this. And when we say digits, okay, so do you know why the why we say it as digits first of all? So what are the digits? What are the 10 digits?
0 to 9.
Perfect. 0 to 9 are the digits. When we write the number 10, is it a digit or what is it? Is it a single digit or there are two digits?
Sir, a digit is single and 10 is a number.
Yeah. We are going to join again. So don't worry. If the Zoom is ending, then we'll join again. Yeah, you are right. So Madhura, please pay attention. So everyone, see, 10 is a number, but not a digit. Digits are only from 0 to 9, right? 0 to 9 are the digits. After that, all the numbers are composed of multiple digits. There might be 2 digits, 3 digits, 4 digits, everything. Just 1 second. Okay, so I think what we'll do is there are about 20 more minutes that I want to cover. So we will take a small break right now. Okay, and we will join back. Okay, it's a 3 minute break. Just 1 second. So So we are going to look at binary and decimal, and there is a purpose, okay? Because this problem that I said, right, it gets automatically solved if you go to the binary system of numbers, and it looks magical, but there is nothing magic. Everything is logic, right? No magic, only logic, right? So we are going to learn about it. So, but it will take at least 20 minutes more, 25 minutes more. So what we'll do is we'll take a small break right now. Okay, I'm going to stop the recording now.